On Tuesday, actors Jeri Ryan posted on social media they have a series wrap on Picard, meaning that they have completed principal photography on the third and final season, just as season two starts rolling out on Paramount Plus. She said she can't wait for people to see what happens in season three. And Trek Central reports via Twitter that Star Trek Discovery is currently filming for season five. They spotted this entry here. Let me see if I got it. I didn't have it. They've spotted an entry in the Directors Guild of Canada production listing. They have shooting that runs from June to November, according to the entry. Gives us a likely premiere sometime mid to late 2023. And on the same day that we get the teaser for Obi-Wan Kenobi, we also got the teaser for Strange New Worlds. Now, personally, I think somebody in marketing at Paramount Plus needs to rethink a few things. I mean, really. The day of the Disney investors call, the day that the cancel mob is going after Disney over Florida and China, the day that they release the Kenobi trailer, you give us the Strange New Worlds trailer. Okay. Anyway. Well, we get in this, we see Tango. It appears Pike gets called back into uniform, possibly out of retirement, which is somewhat consistent with his ruminations from the cage. We also see Spock overlooking a city that may be Sikar. We've got a new planet, new people, not much else to give away plot points. The show debuts on May 5th. What?
Oh, nothing.
Oh. All right. New models from Eagle Moss available for pre-order now, part of their XL Starships collection. The USS Stargazer, as it appeared in Star Trek The Next Generation. Hand-painted, 9 1/4 inches long. This is an update from the die-cast model originally released in 2014. This new edition goes for $55. And the Caretaker's Array from the pilot episode of Voyager, 9 inches tall with all the angled sprues around the central hub of the station. This will run you $75. And then we have this Hierarchy Assault Ship. This is a deep cut from the Voyager episodes Tinker, Tenor, Dr. Spy, and The Void, used by the Hierarchy Onlookers as observation craft. It's 3 1/2 inches. It goes for $35. Eagle Moss is also going to be launching figures. Official Statuettes Collection, 8-inch character figures, starting with Lieutenant Spock, as portrayed by Ethan Peck in Discovery Season 2. No price has been announced for this figure yet. It's available for pre-order soon, they say. And XO6 has announced their new 1/6 scale replica, Captain Picard's command chair from First Contact. The accessory is made for the figures that are already out there, so you can sit Captain Picard in his chair. It's got integrated USB-powered lighting and sound functions. They're also working on a display background, a backdrop that's sold separately, that can put everybody on the bridge of the Enterprise E. The chair is expected for delivery in August. It can be pre-ordered now for $195. And finally, our condolences to the family and friends of Laurel Goodwin, the last remaining original crew member of the Starship Enterprise. She played Yeoman Colt in the original pilot, The Cage. This came 4 years after her acting debut opposite Elvis Presley in Girls, Girls, Girls. And beside her acting career, she also had a producer credit. She and her husband, Hank Moonjean, produced the Burt Reynolds movie Stroker Ace in 1983. Goodwin is survived by her sister. No cause of death was reported. She was 79. And those are your Tribble Bytes for this week. Don't forget to subscribe and share the video with your fellow fans. Connect with us on social media. We will have more as it comes in to us.
Copyright 2022 by Flaming Dog Media, LLC. All rights reserved. No portion of this program may be retransmitted without the express written consent of Flaming Dog Media. You're watching Sci-Fi for Me TV, delivering the multiverse since 2009.